Sometimes even with his large claw, this crab needs extra protection.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Derek Elliott from Derek.com, defender of the crustaceans, you can call me, because today we are going to be defending this little fella here from what I don't know, maybe from at Derek J. Elliott on Instagram. Made a post with this guy the other day and kind of tossed him around, and I feel a little bad about it. Don't hurt animals, especially not crabs. But anyways, I found this little crab model on a website called ThreeDscans. They've got some really cool models available. I'll put a link in the description for that. And they don't come like rigged, and this is by no means rigged, but I screwed around with it a little while and kind of made him do this. And yeah, so what he's doing is raising his hand into the air, or his claw into the air, to summon a force field to protect himself. But the force field isn't there, so we're going to build it for him. You don't have to use a crab, by the way. You can protect whatever you want. You know, take your favorite model, throw it in there. Give it some D. Yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to press Shift A and add an icosphere mesh. Icosphere. It's made out of triangles, but we're going to adjust that. And speaking of these triangles, I want more of them. I want to up the subdivision to 3, which I think is going to give me about what I'm looking for. Kind of a cartoony looking force field. You can do more if you want, make it a little more detailed, but that looks pretty good. Now I am going to bump this size up a little bit. So now if you adjust the size here, I don't think it'll mess up over here. So yeah, the scale's still 1. And if we drag along here, does his claw poke through? No, it doesn't. So I was just making sure it's big enough to fully protect Mr. Crab here. So yeah, with him in there, now we need to make this start looking a little more force fieldy. And I don't know, for some reason, force fields always seem to be made out of like hexagons. So we're going to add a bevel modifier. If you've used bevel modifier before, like if you've watched one of my tutorials, it's like my favorite. It's going to do this, which is what you might expect. And we can actually see these effects a little better if we turn on cavity here. That's not what I want. I'm going to turn on this only vertices options. And then that's going to start to kind of make this hexagon effect. So I think something like that is going to look pretty good. You know, just adjust that to your liking. Kind of going for some even hexagons. Obviously, there's some like kind of weird shapes to happen, but I think they make it look cooler. So that's all put together. I am going to delete the bottom here. You know, he's still got his claws. He's got enough defense. We'll need to protect him from the underground too. I think that'll be more than enough just being up here. So with that there, I'm going to build this out in a couple parts, and there's going to be kind of a wireframe, you know, element to it. Hint, hint, wireframe modifier. And then there's going to be kind of like the main force field that I think we'll split up into a couple sections just to make it look a little more interesting. So I've got that wireframe modifier added. Just get it to a thickness you like, something like that. I think it's going to be good for me. And yeah, that's pretty good. So the other part is not going to have, basically want the same thing, but to kind of fill in the gaps. And if you wanted to make this all in one piece, you could just uncheck this replace original and that would work. But I want it to be separate pieces. So I'm going to just press Shift D to duplicate it. Right click, snap it back where it was. And I am going to remove the wireframe modifier. It still has this bevel. You could adjust this, make them like different, kind of a cool effect, but I ain't going to do it. You should if you want to. Now, for the purposes of keeping things organized, I'm going to name this new one FF1 for force field 1. Force field 1. And then I'm going to name this other one FF wire for force field wire. And yeah, looks pretty good. Got our parts there. Now I am going to move into some materials right away. This, you can, like, at every point of the process here, you can do all sorts of random things to like get different looks and stuff here, but so that people can just follow through with the basics here, I am going to kind of just try to move along here and get all the basic parts together, and then we'll have a little more fun with like the materials, for example. So I've got a shader editor up here. I just got that set up. And now I'm going to switch this into a rendered view so that we can see what's happening. Obviously, you can see I have a few things set up here. Like there was a crab in the scene that doesn't come with typical Blender scenes. But if you do join my Patreon, this file will be available and Mr. Crab will be in there for you to play with. Maybe somebody can show me how to actually animate it, like I said. because I don't think I did it right at all, but it worked out. So we've got our scene set up here. It's like, you know, there's a lamp and a plane. Don't worry about it. We've got our parts, and now I want to add materials to them. I'm going to select the wire. I'm going to press new, and we'll go ahead and name that wire just again so we can keep things organized. And I don't want this principal shader. You could make it like, you know, a metallic frame or something, but I'm just going to have it be an emission shader. So Shift S, switch it to an emission. That's looking cool. By the way, Shift S is only if you have the Node Wrangler add-on enabled. Search for it, enable it. Enjoy your new Node Wrangling life. Got that there. It's looking pretty cool, but it would look cooler with Bloom. We're looking at EEVEE here, so got to use the Bloom, make things glow. Looks pretty cool. All right, that's going to be about it for that material. Again, do whatever you want. I'm going to select the other portion of the force field here. Force field here, and we're going to name it FF for force field. And similarly here, do whatever you want. I'm going to do an emission shader, Shift S, shader emission, but I am going to want to be able to see through this. So I'll also, and before we do that, let's talk a little bit about colors. Force fields are blue. That's all we're going to say about colors. You could do whatever color you want, but I don't know. If you Google force field, like 99 times out of 100, or maybe 98, it's blue. So anyways, we got to make it so we can see through this. I'm going to add a shader. It's going to be transparent so that we can, you know, see through it. And now I want to mix these together. I want a little emission. I want a little transparency. So we'll use a mix shader. But again, with the Node Wrangler add-on enabled, I can press Shift, Control, right click and drag, and it'll mix those together automatically. That is a very cool feature. Again, Node Wrangler add-on, use it, it's good. So, but now, if you don't know how to mix shader works, by the way, 0 would be the first input, 1 would be fully the second input, and, you know, 0.5 would be a mix, like a halfway mix. But even if we drag this all the way up to 0.9, we're not really getting the effect of that transparency, and that's because we're working in EEVEE, and we need to make a couple adjustments to the material settings down here. So what I'll do is change the blend mode from opaque to alpha blend. I found works pretty well. And then similarly with the shadows, I'm just going to turn it off because I don't know. It seems like a good property of force fields to not cast shadows. You know, I don't know. It just seems like a good thing. Okay. Don't ask me any questions about why I turned the shadows off. And for this material, I'll also just turn, we're not going to mess with transparency, but I'll just change that to alpha blend too. And we'll turn off the shadow here too. As cool as this little thing is, I don't want it. I'll turn it off. So yeah, we've got kind of the basics of our force field set up here. We could turn off our overlays, take a look at it, just kind of admire Mr. Crab living his best life, protected from mean at Derek J. Elliott's. Yeah, that looks good. Turn those overlays back on. And let's go ahead now and set up a little bit of animation. So what I'll do is find the frame where I have Mr. Crab set up here. He snaps his claw out of pure disgust from his surroundings to summon his force field around frame 108. And yeah, and then that's when we want the force field to appear. So I'm going to, you know, so at frame 108, it should be 0. The scale of these objects should be 0. And then maybe over the course of like 30 frames, so 138, we'll have it bump up to the, you know, proper scale of 1. So with that selected, I'm going to click and drag here to select all those values. And it's already at 1. So yeah, right click, insert keyframes. Similarly on this one, right click, insert keyframes. So now those have their scale value set as 1 at frame 138. I like that. And then at frame 108, like right when he snaps is kind of when they'll appear. So maybe, yeah, like frame 108. I think that's pretty good. So let's click and drag. Let's set that to 0. Right click, insert keyframes. And then on this one, click and drag, 0. Right click, insert keyframes. And now the force field appears. It's amazing. And for the purposes of previewing this, I'm going to drag my start frame up to, yeah, like something like that. And I could even drag my end frame back a little bit. That's just so when we're pressing spacebar to preview this, we're not having to watch the whole little sequence beforehand. But, you know, put the animation wherever you need to on the timeline. So with that all together, it's looking kind of cool. But how do we make it look cooler? Well, there's a couple ways. There's like an insane number of ways. But I'm going to change this to a graph editor. And then I'm going to start showing you some cool stuff. So let's select both of these. And then I'm going to press, so I can't see where in my graph editor this is. So I'm just going to press A and then period. A will select them all and then period on my number pad will zoom to them. And now we can see that's our little, that's our graph right there. So that's kind of what's happening. Now, again, many things you can do here, but there's some really cool, you could adjust the curves, which is something, you know, I'd normally do. And if you wanted to make some super high quality animation, you would do, but I'm going to press T and I can change some effects here. So there's a couple cool ones built in. Elastic is going to do that. That's looking pretty cool. Let's select this again. We could also change it to bounce, which is going to do that. So it's kind of, these are just some kind of cool built-in effects. The one I like though, pretty simple, is just called back. Crab got back, baby got back. I don't know. It's like a, it just, it does that. You could build that manually with the Bezier curve settings, but the dynamic effects, just they work pretty good right out of the box. So yeah, leave it at that. I'm gonna leave it at back, but this is still pretty boring. It just kind of all pops into place like that. And by the way, if you're a beginner and this is stressing you out too much already, you're welcome to leave at this point. The rest of us are going to move on to more cool stuff, but this is the basics. We've kind of covered the materials, a little bit of animation, a little bit of modeling. Let's move into these two intermediate people. And yeah, so what we're going to do, I'm going to kind of offset this animation a little bit so that they don't happen at the same time. So what I can do is just select, for example, maybe the wire comes first and then the force field comes second. So what I can do is just like press A to select everything, G, and just kind of move this over. And that will kind of make it, make them happen at different times. And I just think that that looks kind of cool. You know, so you can see if we select them both, it's like one happens and the other. But one thing that I think is even cooler that you could do is split that force field object up into multiple parts. So instead of just having that one dome, you can select that object. Let's turn our overlays back on. And then let's break it into two pieces. So I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode. Oops. And to do this, let's go ahead and apply the bevel modifier so we can actually have, you know, a little more control over those individual hexagons. Yeah, like that. Let's hide the wire for now. Which, by the way, if you want to have these filters up here, like I have the selection thing, you can adjust what appears here, like, you know, your render toggle and stuff. But I got that there. Now I want to split this into a couple pieces. So let's, for one, it's a good idea to make these changes when you're, when there's no animation happening. So I'm going to just go over there, frame 169, and I'm going to select, I'm going to press 3 to go on my face select. I want to just get like kind of half these. I want to split it up. So what I'm going to do is just select a face there, and then I'm going to press F3 to search, and I'm going to select similar, not similar regions. I don't know what that does, why there's two. I don't know. Select similar, and then you have a whole host of options here. This is a very cool way to make abstract objects and stuff, but I'm going to select perimeter, and that's going to select similar vertices, edges, or faces by perimeter. Yeah. So that's going to just select ones that have the same perimeter. So it'll get kind of a nice even pattern. But you know, you can turn this threshold up, select some more, get whatever kind of cool effect you want. You know, maybe you want to also add ones that have this perimeter. So you can do the same thing, select similar perimeter. It'll add those ones. And now we got a pretty good looking kind of balance here. I think that looks all right. Maybe we, let's leave it at that. We got a good alternating amount there. So I'm going to press P now and separate by selection. So now what I have are two objects. And let's go ahead and before I drive myself crazy, let's name that FF2 so we can keep track of them. So those are obviously happening together, but maybe we want that object offset too. So like, let's move this. Oh, okay. But now when we move it, it's moving both of them. And that's because when I duplicated it, or when I separated it, it kept the animation data with it. So what I need to do is now give that its own animation data. So what I'm going to do is Again, with F3 to search. Actually, I think you could do it over here. Yeah, object. And then somewhere around here. There's like data, but I'm going to search for it. So I want to make it a single user of the selected objects of the animation. Select that. And then now this should have its own animation data. So now when we move it, yes, it's moving independently. So maybe that part of the force field happens, you know, sooner or something. So it's like, yeah, so that blasts, then that blasts, and then they settle in together. So we can turn back on our wire. So now with that, oh yeah, very cool effect here. And you know, maybe we even want this to all happen faster, so we can select them all, and then like SX, it'll kind of just scale in the animation so it's like faster. We'll leave it how it was. I think that looks pretty cool. So again, you know, split this into as many pieces as you want, do whatever you want, but let's now move into playing with these materials, I think just a little bit more is what I want to do next. So that's the basics of the animation. Let's do one more thing. So there's a really cool thing that I did, or I don't know, I'm very vain. I thought it was cool. Maybe you don't. But instead of having this wireframe pop out like fully formed, you can kind of have it like build into place. Hint, hint, with a build modifier, add modifier, build. And what that's going to do is it basically builds the object. But the way it works is the build will start at the designated frame here, which for us, you know, frame one is way back here. We're not even viewing that part of the animation. And then it'll happen over the course of the length specified here. So I want this to start building at probably like, start building at like frame 108 or so. I think that's about where we started our animation. And then we'll have it, see, you can, I'll show you what it's doing here. And then have it last maybe like 40 frames or something. So that's what the build does. It just kind of builds, but it does like any modifier, it works in order. So I'm gonna pop this up to the top. So we want it to have an after the bevel. So yeah, just right there should be good. So just kind of build these hexagons one at a time. That's looking good. And now I think I kind of want to adjust this. I want this wire to happen first. It's kind of cool because it makes it look like there's like this wire that just comes out. All right, let's move these back a little bit. Again, folks, I'm sorry. This is the part of the tutorial where I just start having fun. If you're not having fun, get out of here. We're having fun together. This is the cool part of the tutorial. So yeah, adjusting those, just trying to get it to look good. So it kind of assembles over time. I think that looks pretty good. And now, so yeah, it kind of pops out. Looking sweet. And actually, okay, since we're wasting time here, we're going to do cool stuff. There's another thing you can do with the build, which is to change the seed. So randomize, instead of having it kind of build in a more even way, randomize will just make a build from like anywhere. And you can actually change the seed value. So let's just like set the seed value there to something and then set it here to like another something. And then it'll flash into existence. That's pretty cool. And you could similarly, you know, you could do the build on these, do whatever you want. You know, maybe we throw it on there just for the heck of it, you know, have it start at frame 1 and 12, last 30 seconds or 30 frames, 21 frames. Boom. Cool effect. Okay. So now just a couple more cool effects with the materials. Let's go over here into our shader editor. And now one thing that I think looks pretty cool is once this forms, I don't want it to just be like a steady, or, you know, during its formation, I don't want this just to be this flat blue color. So what I can do, let's actually bump that strength up a little bit, make it pop. So what I can actually do is add some animation, like a texture on the force field material itself. So I'm going to do that with a noise texture. So I'm going to press, let's see here. I'm just going to add the noise texture. So texture, noise. And then we can use this to control the amount of mixing going on or the color. Let's change the amount of mixing going on. So let's also add a converter color ramp. Plug these in. And then now if I plug this into the mix value, okay, so that's going to do something a little funky. All right, so we're getting into our advanced principles here. I'm going to press Control T on this noise texture, change this to an object input. Okay, so that's too big, too small. What I'm going to do basically is just, I want this kind of like pattern to be spread across the object. Let's bring our color ramp in on itself so we can see that a little more. Maybe give it some distortion, you know, to make it force fieldy. Something like that I think looks pretty cool. Okay, so again, black is a value of 0, white is 1. So the black areas would be getting full emission. The white areas would be getting full transparency. So when we plug that all together, let's see what that looks like. Okay, so that is pretty cool, but I don't want any parts to be fully transparent or fully emissive. So I'm gonna change the black to like a light gray, something like that, and the white to, you know, another light gray, something like that. So now we have just this kind of subtle texture happening there. A little more exciting than just the flat color. But now let's say we want to animate that so it looks like it's moving around. Well, we can just add some keyframes here on the mapping. So, you know, you could adjust the rotation if you wanted to do that. Or, you know, you can adjust the location, which I think in this case is going to look cool. So, yeah, I think that let's like make it look like it's kind of like coating, like it's like falling down. So that would be the Z value needs to move forward. So let's set a keyframe here. Insert a single keyframe at 0, and then over here, insert a single keyframe at like 17, something like that. Okay, so it's moving a little too fast. Let's jump to where that keyframe was. I think I put it right there. And you could actually make these adjustments in the graph editor too. Let's just do something like that. Replace single keyframe. Okay, so now we have kind of a very subtle effect. Now, if you wanted this to ease, you can leave it how it is, or select that mapping node, go into the graph editor, and then we can we should have access to it right here. So let's hide this, and let's make it like a linear, so that it just like moves at a constant rate. All right, I think that's looking pretty cool, guys and girls. Whoever needs force fields, watch the tutorial. That's looking pretty good. I think I'm gonna leave it at that. You know, you could do a whole bunch of other stuff. You could like have this like rotate when it comes in. So maybe it's like 0 rotation there, and then it like spins 360 or something. And when it comes in, like that'd be kind of cool. Actually, I don't like that. I'm gonna undo that. But do whatever you want. Have fun with it. I really appreciate y'all watching. Again, if you want access to this exact file, I'll have it on my Patreon. It will include Mr. Crab here and access to all my other tutorial files, by the way, too. That's kind of the reward on my Patreon. It's not about the rewards, though. It's about just saying thanks to Papa Derek for making these tutorials. Anyways, I really appreciate y'all watching. Have some fun with this. Would love to see what you come up with. Would love to see who you put inside, who, what, or what you put inside your force field. Anyways, that's it. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Like and subscribe. Should I do more with this? This is always the part of the tutorial where I'm like, I could have done more. There could be cooler things here. Nah, I think this looks cool. Let's maybe, nah, let's leave it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace.